So when I started, I was about three. So I was just watching my brother play with my parents, and I just got involved with him. And then they just kind of let me join in when there was an age group around my age, three and four. So it was all boys and just me. And I didn't join a girls team until I was about seven. I don't think my parents knew that they were available. So yeah, it was just me really, playing against the boys. Yeah. So that's very fun. but I think it's important to play against boys when you're young, to get that physical element in the game. And it's always quite nice when you come up against the boys and they're like, oh, we've got a girl in the team, and you know, you always show them up. So
yeah. Yeah, no, I can imagine. Fair play to you for like not really being fazed by being the only girl in the
team. I honestly didn't really think about it. I guess you just play because you love it, and you don't really think of the fact you're the only girl in the team. I didn't really know if there were any other girls in any other teams, really, in my sort of league or whatever it was back then. So yeah, it was just me really, with my brother and my school friends in a local team. And then yeah, I didn't join a girls team until I was around seven, and then it was just girls from then on, and then Centre of Excellence, and then all the way through from that. Well, I think when I was younger, I used to just go anywhere, any position that I could attack in, I'd go anywhere, so winger, striker. But when it became more of a serious game coming into like my professional career, I kind of went into the midfield, sort of 10 role, primarily because of my height, I like to attack, that sort of thing. But yeah, mainly midfield really, the last kind of 10 years or whatever. So at the time I was playing for Bristol City, and I was on a 2-year deal with them, but I wanted to get some more playing time, and the opportunity to go out on loan came up, and a couple of clubs contacted me, and the Lionesses were obviously a new club, it looked really exciting, and the manager at the time contacted me and asked me to go down for a training session, and I really liked what they had to offer, and it was really exciting. So for the remainder of that year, I would potentially go on loan, but they actually offered me a permanent deal that was better that I could have got from the loan. So I took it, and it's just never really looked back since. It's been really good. So that's how it kind of came about. I didn't know there was a Lionesses before that, because obviously they were Millwall before, but I didn't know that there was the change and the opportunity for the Lionesses. So yeah. Yeah, it's really nice. Really nice stadium, to be fair. And I like that we get to train on there as well. It's all at one complex. So we train, we play, gym. Yeah, so that's not often you get that in the women's game generally. So it's quite cool. Well, when I joined Bristol, I was about 13, 14 in the Centre of Excellence. So I didn't really know at the time that women's football like professionally existed, that you could create a career out of it. I was just doing it because I loved it. And then I found out there was a Bristol Academy at the time, and there was like a Super League. But yeah, I didn't really know that there was that pathway. And now you look and you got Women's Super League and the FA Women's Championship and all the scope around the England women's team, and the amount of people watching England at Wembley, like the like improvement or whatever you call it, investment that you've got in the last 5-6 years is like amazing when you think about it, really. And you don't tend to think about it when you're a part of it, but when you do, it's like, wow, it's going somewhere, and it's really exciting to be a part of. So I'd say it's exciting for the young kids as well to have the idea that there are opportunities for them to play, because I would always look at Steven Gerrard and be like, wow, but that I could never do something like that, but like you could for a young girl nowadays. So
yeah, definitely, there's definitely sort of room for a Stephanie Gerrard around now, like
yeah. Yeah, definitely agree. And I mean, I might be a little bit biased, but I actually think sometimes women's football is a bit more exciting to watch. So I think men's football is too good that they just keep the ball and it's just a bit boring. Like, yeah, sometimes, exactly, whereas women's football is a little bit more end-to-end and you don't know what's going to happen. There could be, mm-hmm, like 5-6 goals at each game. So I think there's that element of it as well. I hope so. I think it is really good for women's football, and obviously we're one of the first. So if people or teams are watching and they see the success that we could have in a couple of years' time and where we're progressing, maybe they would be more inclined to do something like that and step away from the men's team. So I think you'll definitely see more teams doing it. And obviously we have Diane, the chairwoman, who is just amazing for us. And if you have that backing and support, she's like one of our number one fans. So if you have that support from someone like the investment behind, then I think it would be perfect for any club to do, really. And we're creating our own and things, so it's quite cool, really. There's a funny story that every time I go somewhere with my nan, she'll tell anybody and everybody that I'm a professional footballer, and they're always like, wow. And then I guess in those moments I kind of realise, oh, it's quite cool actually, because you don't really say it too much. But yeah, I guess it's just not that common for a woman professional football, or people don't necessarily know about it. Because when they think of football, they think of the men in the Premier League. So I think people think it's quite cool and exciting. So, and for me, because I'm little and, I don't know, maybe not the stereotypical look of what they think a footballer would look like, they're always quite shocked that I am a footballer. So I do get that quite a lot. But so at the time I just left school and I loved graphics and photography, and I had the opportunity to move to Bristol and play full time alongside studying with the college, because that was the setup they had and it was really good. So I decided to do graphics and photography, and I absolutely loved it because I'm quite creative and I like that sort of side of things. But for me now, it's probably more of a hobby than a career. If opportunities come up where I can take it into career, then I might do. But for now, it's something I just do as a hobby alongside football, with football being full time.
Yeah,
I've done in the past sports photography and just kind of day-to-day artsy stuff with it. So yeah, it's something that just allowed me to do football full time, and I absolutely loved it. But for a career more later on in life, I'd like to go into physiotherapy or something like that. So maybe go to university at some point and study that sort of thing, but I still do love my creative side. I would say as a collective year, we wanted to achieve more, so we had the sights of promotion, obviously finishing fourth last year, but sometimes results don't go your way and things like that, but we're definitely building, and next year that's our sort of goal. So I say, that, and a game that stood out, one probably the Leicester game. I didn't actually play because I had a quad injury, but as a team, I think we really showed up and we proved like what we could be and do, and we'd had some sort of off results before, and we had a few doubters and things like that, and then we beat the top of the league, who were unbeaten, 4-1. I'd say that game, and personally for me, playing a friendly against Tottenham, No, it wasn't the friendly. It was the, I think it was the County Cup game.
County Cup, you got player of the match.
County Cup. Yeah. County Cup. Because that was the first game I'd felt, probably in my career, that, like, I don't know, that excitement and love for the game. Like, oh, I'm a bit tricky here. Or I just had some moments where I felt like, yeah, like, I'm actually quite good. I feel like I played better against the top teams, but I just, that game on a personal level, I felt like this is why I'm doing it. Like I just really enjoyed that game, some of the moments, even though we lost. Like I just felt like that game probably stood out for me and probably in my career, just because of the things that just happened in that game.
Totally, yeah.
You did incredible that game. I'll support that as well. Like, I remember watching it. It's so good. Like, and she got player of the match, but she was just, like, in the midfield. You're just receiving, distributing, like, just, yeah. I was, yeah. Very, very good pop.
Thanks. Yeah, and it's going to be a good league as well, because I've heard rumours of potentially one or two teams coming up, and it could be like Birmingham or West Ham or Bristol coming down. So it's going to be a real good league to play in, really competitive, and a fight at the top to go up. So it will be exciting, and hopefully fans can be back in as well. So that would be a nice element to it. So, because it was only really for like the first 6 months, and then we went into lockdown.
Yeah.
I don't think we've really created a fan base that we have now anyway. So it was around, you might be able to answer a better, Bree, maybe around 200, was it?
No, that's 300? Correct. It's around a couple hundred.
Yeah. Yes, but I think we're going to have a lot more with the academy set up we've now got, and a little bit more of a fan base online. So I think we'll get a few more.